The Corsini estate, Villa La Corti, sits atop a hillside outside Florence in the Tuscan wine region of Chianti, on land the family has owned since the 1300s.
Do I rightly address you as Princess Corsini?
Principessa.
Principessa.
Yes,
Principessa
that's right.
Corsini.
Princess Giorgiana Corsini, along with her husband, Filippo, head the family now. Merchants and bankers for more than 600 years, the Corsinis built much of their fortune during the Renaissance, a fortune largely devoted to preserving the art and architecture of Florence.
They thought that art was really the good and important and universal message, and the message that could survive during generations and generations.
Royalty has been in the family since 1730, when Lorenzo Corsini was elected Pope Clement XII at age 78, creating the official royal bloodline. He's best known for commissioning the Trevi Fountain in Rome. But for more than a century, Villa La Corti was left to sit empty, and time took its toll.
I tried to, to restore, to maintain.
She decided to bring the house and ancient winery back to life for her son, Prince Duccio, and his family.
Oh!
This is the family tree.
Yes, that is.
It starts from the Middle Ages.
The ones that have little portraits, what is the significance of?
They're important.
They are.
Today, one of Italy's historical treasures sits behind the villa's walls.
It's our family's history. It is the history of Italy.
Spread throughout 11 rooms in an untouched part of the house.
So this is an accounting book.
Virtually every piece of paper ever recorded by the Corsinis dating back to 1020. Wills, love letters, even receipts preserved for history.
There is no plumbing, no electricity, no heating, just to preserve the papers as they have been preserved for centuries.
The rich family legacy of one of Italy's richest families under one Tuscan roof.